Hey everyone, I hope you had a great day. Today we are looking at some new r/I-do-work-here-lady stories. I hope you enjoy them. The first story is called I'm a Safety Hazard. I'm 18 and just started at a big chain auto parts store, even though I know little to nothing about vehicles and how to fix them. A family member got me in, but I'm getting by fairly well and haven't had a complaint about my advice yet. Even though I'm 18, I'm very short and have a big baby face, so I often get mistaken for being 12 despite having pastel pink hair and a nose piercing. So this happened last week when I was stocking and facing shelves about half an hour before closing. For us, it's mandatory to have the store fully stocked and neat before leaving for the night. Our stores are equipped with very tall rolling ladders, clearly marked employees only, to help safely stock heavy parts on higher shelves. It was late, so there was barely anyone in the store. I was stocking the top shelves, where we keep our car wash supplies. Then I noticed this lady, dressed in high-end business clothes, a rarity here, that keeps staring at me. I finally ask her if there's anything I can help her find, and the following conversation ensues. Young lady, you know those ladders are for employees only, right? I was a bit confused because I was literally stocking shelves and had the employee uniform on with my name stitched on it. Yes ma'am, I work here. I just started a few weeks ago. I pointed to the logo on my work shirt. The woman is looking me up and down. Aren't you a little young to be working here? I thought they didn't hire until 18. I am 18. My birthday was in January and I just started here. She started screaming. Don't lie to me! Get down from there, right now! Else, I'm going to get you kicked out for lying and playing on store equipment. Startled, I tell her, no, I work here. I'm just doing my job. And I attempt to continue stocking the shelves when she grabs my ankle and tries to pull me off the 6-foot ladder. Keep in mind, these ladders are as old as the store and aren't the most sturdy. So I grip the handles and pray it doesn't fall over while I yell at her to leave me alone. You shouldn't be up there. You could get hurt. Oh, this irony. At this point, my coworker hears the commotion and comes out the back to see what's going on. She walks around the corner to see me shaking my leg, trying to get out of her grip before the ladder falls over. I'm also trying hard not to start crying, as I'm terribly afraid of heights. Ma'am, what are you doing? Stop it. She could fall. She shouldn't even be up there. She doesn't work here. While she was distracted, I quickly shake my ankle out of her grip and speed down the ladder and over to my coworker. I demand that she will be banned from the store for being disruptive and a safety hazard. Ma'am, she works here. We just hired her 2 weeks ago. Then prove it. Show me her schedule and her ID. Now. First of all, no. I'm not showing you my schedule so you can come here and harass me. Secondly, I'm not showing you my ID. I don't have anything to prove to you. Please leave the store before I call the police. Oh, I will gladly call the police. And with that, she pulls out her phone and dials 911. At this point, I'm so shaken up and tired and just want to go home. So my coworker sends me to the back to try to finish up my duties before we close. About 10 minutes later, the police shows up and the woman starts screaming about how I was being a safety hazard and kicked her in the face. The police looks at me and again assumed I'm only 12 until my coworker explains to them what actually happened. The police requested the security footage, which we happily showed them. Of course, it caught the woman physically harassing me. She started yelling that she was only looking out for my safety and did nothing wrong. Obviously, the cops didn't buy it. They told her that if she was truly concerned for my safety, she should have taken it up with the manager on duty instead of physically harassing an employee. They escorted her out, where she continued screaming. I told them I did not want to press charges since she probably did not live here anyway. It's a fairly small town and an everyone knows everyone type of deal, and I'd never seen her before. It's been about a week since the incident and I haven't seen her since, thankfully. but I think it's safe to say I may not last long in this business. Do you enjoy the video? Then please hit the like button and leave a comment. It's really important so that the channel can grow. The next story is called You Need a Gold Wristband. I used to work as an entertainment lighting electrician and console programmer. One of my busiest times of the year was working New York Fashion Week, both spring and fall. It was a lot of organized chaos, but I enjoyed my time there. The most important place backstage is the hair and makeup stations in the dressing rooms. Rows of tables with mirrors and lights, with power for the hairstylist and makeup artist for things like blow dryers and curling irons, and courtesy power for the models for phones and such. While we try to make sure that each station has at least two dedicated 20 amp circuits, invariably someone will come in and plug the equipment into the same power strip as the workstation next to them, and it will trip a breaker. Now, one-way shows are absolute chaos backstage. Models, hairdressers, makeup artists, production assistants, press, designers, it gets pretty crowded backstage. Security is understandably tight during this whole process. But guards don't actually come in until the day of the show. Because we are already in the space long before the show actually starts, I always try to introduce myself to the security guards so they know who I am. Usually, wearing a radio and a tool belt is enough for most people to clue in who we are. And if that fails, the all-access pass or wristband seals in. But I always like to take the extra step and be prepared. So one fine show day, I get a frantic call on my radio from the lead production assistant. Help! There's no power at the hair and makeup stations! Now, if it's actually just one station that's out or all of them, it doesn't really make a difference. Even having one station out can be an emergency. So I start making my way over. On my way, I encounter the assistant, who looks very relieved to see me and motions for me to follow. Backstage is packed to the gills, so she makes it to the dressing room entrance a little bit before I do. As I'm about to go in, I get stopped by security. Unfortunately, it's not the same guy that was at the dressing rooms before the show, when I was introducing myself, so this guy doesn't know me. Models only backstage. It's okay, I'm on the tag team. I show him my white wristband. Nice try. Gold wristbands only backstage. He grabs my arm and starts pulling me away from the dressing room entrance. You need to go. Just then, I get another call on my radio. Where are you? I key my mic and respond, I'm being escorted out by security at the moment. Something has now finally clicked in the security guy's head. Unfortunately for him, he was too slow to respond. The assistant comes storming out of the dressing room. Security, what the heck are you doing? He works here. He's my electrician. Let him go. But he doesn't have a gold wristband. Gold is for dressing room only. White is for all access. Now let go of him. He let go of me, apologized, and I went about my business. I don't disparage the man for trying to do his job, but he probably should have been paying more attention when his boss was going over wristband colors for the day. The last story is called I Know Every Owner. My parents used to own a small cafe in a small shopping mall. I was 13 at the time. This event was around a week before we closed down, but I still remembered it. My parents used to come there once a week to check in and brought me along. Since we didn't have much staff, only one or two people, I used to help out by welcoming, greeting customers and taking their orders. Well, one lucky day, along comes Karen, all ready to make my day as wonderful as possible. I did the usual drill, open the door and welcome her. If the cafe is full, I normally tell guests if they have to wait or show them to a table. Karen came at a time when the cafe was almost empty, so she obviously could just sit anywhere. There was just one more customer, a nice middle-aged man in the corner. The cafe had a separate room with an opening to go into, which was for smokers. My parents were in there for privacy, but could see me most of the time. I go to Karen's table 1 minute later to take her order. She was seated on a table right next to the door. Are you ready to order, ma'am? She stares at me. What? Are you ready to order? Kid, I don't have time for your BS. You played around when I came in. Now screw off to wherever the heck your parents are before I call someone to get you out. Now I'm wearing an employee tag with my name on it and I'm pretty taken aback by her rude response. Ma'am, I work here. I gesture to my tag. That is obviously a fake. Wait till I tell the owner about you and have you banned. I'm best friends with him. Well, my mom is the owner and she said him, so you get the point. Ma'am, first of all, I do work here. And the owners are right there. If you know them, then you can ask them about me. How dare you talk back to me like that? You know what? She grabs my arm. I will do this place a favor and get rid of you for them. She gets up and drags me out the door. My parents have a view of the door and see me being dragged out. So do the employees and they rush over to free me. Let my son go. She gets me out of her grip. What do you think you are doing? How dare you touch me? I will report all of you to the owner. I am best friend with him. I am the owner. Liar, prove it. She slightly gives my mom a hard push on the shoulder. More security had been observing all of this from a distance and is slowly coming closer. We will see about that. She gestures to the guards to come here. This woman is completely ignoring the fact that she saw my mom gesture for the guards.
Ha! Let's see you get thrown out for harassing me.
Then she turns to the guards.
Please help! They harassed me and pushed me and shoved me. And that little brat abused and talked back to me.
The guards saw everything and said, sure, let's go talk about it. The woman went white as a ghost.
What? You are gonna throw me out? I know the mall's owner.
Great, then let's go see him. He would love to know what you did. I went home with my mom and we left our dad to deal with it since I was having a breakdown and couldn't stop crying. He came home and told us that the woman bawled and literally fell down in front of the manager who she was taken to. She apologized to my dad a lot and said how she was just under a lot of stress. My father couldn't take it that this woman had laid a hand on me and talked with the manager. In the end, they finally agreed on banning her from the mall and let her be on her way. The authorities did show up, but by then the issue was resolved and she was sent on her way. It might be something to laugh about today, but boy, I wish I never see another Karen again. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more content. Have a great day and stay safe. Bye bye.